Numbers 1. Now the Lord spoke to Moses, in the wilderness of Sinai, in the tabernacle of meeting, on the first day of the second month, in the second year, after they had come out of the land of Egypt, saying, 2. Take a census of all the congregation of the children of Israel, by their families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of names, every male individually. 3. From 20 years old and above, all who are able to go to war in Israel. You and Aaron shall number them by their armies. 4. And with you there shall be a man from every tribe, each one the head of his father's house. 5. These are the names of the men who shall stand with you: from Reuben, Elizur the son of Shedur. 6. From Simeon, Shelumiel the son of Zurishaddai. 7. From Judah, Nashon the son of Amminadab. 8. From Issachar, Nethanel the son of Zuar. 9. From Zebulun, Eliab the son of Helon. 10. From the sons of Joseph, from Ephraim, Elishama the son of Amid; from Manasseh, Gamaliel the son of Pedazur. 11. From Benjamin, Abidan the son of Gideoni. 12. From Dan, Ahitzer the son of Amishadai. 13. From Asher, Pagiel the son of Okran. 14. From Gad, Eliasaph the son of Duel. 15. From Naphtali, Ahir the son of Anan. 16. These were chosen from the congregation, leaders of their fathers' tribes, heads of the divisions in Israel. 17. Then Moses and Aaron took these men, who had been mentioned by name. 18. And they assembled all the congregation together on the first day of the second month, and they recited their ancestry by families, by their fathers' houses, according to the number of names, from 20 years old and above, each one individually. 19. As the Lord commanded Moses, so he numbered them in the wilderness of Sinai. 20. Now the children of Reuben, Israel's oldest son, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, according to the number of names, every male individually, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 21. Those who were numbered of the tribe of Reuben were 46,500. 22. From the children of Simeon, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, of those who were numbered, according to the number of names, every male individually, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 23. Those who were numbered of the tribe of Simeon were 59,300. 24. From the children of Gad, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, according to the number of names, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 25. Those who were numbered of the tribe of Gad were 45,650. 26. From the children of Judah, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, according to the number of names, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 27. Those who were numbered of the tribe of Judah were 74,600. 28. From the children of Issachar, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, according to the number of names, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 29. Those who were numbered of the tribe of Issachar were 54,400. 30. From the children of Zebulun, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, according to the number of names, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 31. Those who were numbered of the tribe of Zebulun were 57,400. 32. From the sons of Joseph, the children of Ephraim, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, according to the number of names, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 33. Those who were numbered of the tribe of Ephraim were 40,500. 34. From the children of Manasseh, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, according to the number of names, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 35. Those who were numbered of the tribe of Manasseh were 32,200. 36. From the children of Benjamin, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, according to the number of names, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 37. Those who were numbered of the tribe of Benjamin were 35,400. 38. From the children of Dan, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, according to the number of names, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 39. Those who were numbered of the tribe of Dan were 62,700. 40 from the children of Asher, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, according to the number of names, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 41 Those who were numbered of the tribe of Asher were 41,500. 42 From the children of Naphtali, their genealogies by their families, by their father's house, according to the number of names, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war. 43 Those who were numbered of the tribe of Naphtali were 53,400. 44 These are the ones who were numbered, whom Moses and Aaron numbered, with the leaders of Israel, 12 men, each one representing his father's house. 45 So all who were numbered of the children of Israel, by their father's houses, from 20 years old and above, all who were able to go to war in Israel. 46 All who were numbered were 603,550. 47 But the Levites were not numbered among them by their father's tribe. 48 For the Lord had spoken to Moses, saying, 49 Only the tribe of Levi you shall not number, nor take a census of them among the children of Israel. 50 But you shall appoint the Levites, over the tabernacle of the testimony, over all its furnishings, and over all things that belong to it. They shall carry the tabernacle, and all its furnishings, they shall attend to it, and camp around the tabernacle. 51 And when the tabernacle is to go forward, the Levites shall take it down, and when the tabernacle is to be set up, the Levites shall set it up. The outsider who comes near shall be put to death. 52 The children of Israel shall pitch their tents, every one by his own camp, every one by his own standard, according to their armies. 53 But the Levites shall camp round the tabernacle of the testimony, that there may be no wrath on the congregation of the children of Israel, and the Levites shall keep charge of the tabernacle of the testimony. 54 Thus the children of Israel did according to all that the Lord commanded Moses, so they did. 2 And the Lord spoke to Moses and Aaron, saying, To every one of the children of Israel shall camp by his own standard, beside the emblems of his father's house, they shall camp some distance from the tabernacle of meeting. 3 On the east side, toward the rising of the sun, those of the standard of the forces with Judah shall camp according to their armies, and Nahshon the son of Amminadab shall be the leader of the children of Judah. 4 And his army was numbered at 74,600. 5 Those who camp next to him shall be the tribe of Issachar, and Nethanel the son of Zuar shall be the leader of the children of Issachar. 6 And his army was numbered at 54,400. 7 Then comes the tribe of Zebulun, and Eliab the son of Helon shall be the leader of the children of Zebulun. 8 And his army was numbered at 57,400. 9 All who were numbered according to their armies of the forces with Judah, 186,400, these shall break camp first. 10 On the south side shall be the standard of the forces with Reuben according to their armies, and the leader of the children of Reuben shall be Elizur the son of Shedur. 11 And his army was numbered at 46,500. 12 Those who camp next to him shall be the tribe of Simeon, and the leader of the children of Simeon shall be Shalumiel the son of Zurishaddai. 13 And his army was numbered at 59,300. 14 Then comes the tribe of Gad, and the leader of the children of Gad shall be Eliasaph the son of Reuel. 15 And his army was numbered at 45,650. 16 All who were numbered according to their armies of the forces with Reuben, 151,450, they shall be the second to break camp. 17 And the tabernacle of meeting shall move out with the camp of the Levites, in the middle of the camps, as they camp, so they shall move out, every one in his place, by their standards. 18 On the west side shall be the standard of the forces with Ephraim according to their armies, and the leader of the children of Ephraim shall be Elishama the son of Ammid. 19 And his army was numbered at 40,500. 20 Next to him comes the tribe of Manasseh, and the leader of the children of Manasseh shall be Gamaliel the son of Pedazur. 21 And his army was numbered at 32,200. 22 Then comes the tribe of Benjamin, and the leader of the children of Benjamin shall be Abidan the son of Gideoni. 23 And his army was numbered at 35,400. 24 All who were numbered according to their armies of the forces with Ephraim, 108,100, they shall be the third to break camp. 25 The standard of the forces with Dan shall be on the north side according to their armies, and the leader of the children of Dan shall be Ahitzer the son of Amishadai. 26 and his army was numbered at 62,700. 27 Those who camp next to him shall be the tribe of Asher, and the leader of the children of Asher shall be Pagiel the son of Ochran. 28 And his army was numbered at 41,500. 29 Then comes the tribe of Naphtali, and the leader of the children of Naphtali shall be Ahira the son of Enan. 30 And his army was numbered at 53,400. 31 All who were numbered of the forces with Dan, 157,600, they shall break camp last, with their standards. 32 These are the ones who were numbered of the children of Israel, by their fathers' houses. All who were numbered according to their armies of the forces were 603,550. 33 But the Levites were not numbered among the children of Israel, just as the Lord commanded Moses. 34 Thus the children of Israel did according to all that the Lord commanded Moses, so they camped by their standards, and so they broke camp, each one by his family, according to their fathers' houses. 3 Now these are the records of Aaron and Moses, when the Lord spoke with Moses on Mount Sinai. 2 And these are the names of the sons of Aaron, Nadab, the firstborn, and Abiha, Eleazar, and Ithamar. 3 These are the names of the sons of Aaron, the anointed priests, whom he consecrated to minister as priests. 4 Nadab and Abiha had died before the Lord, when they offered profane fire, before the Lord in the wilderness of Sinai, and they had no children. So Eleazar and Ithamar ministered as priests in the presence of Aaron their father. 5 And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, 6 Bring the tribe of Levi, near, and present them, before Aaron the priest, that they may serve him. 7 And they shall attend to his needs, and the needs of the whole congregation, before the tabernacle of meeting, to do the work of the tabernacle. 8 Also they shall attend to all the furnishings of the tabernacle of meeting, and to the needs of the children of Israel, to do the work of the tabernacle. 9 And you shall give the Levites to Aaron, and his sons, they are given entirely to him from among the children of Israel. 10 So you shall appoint Aaron, and his sons, and they shall attend to their priesthood, but the outsider, who comes near shall be put to death. 11 Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, 12 Now behold, I myself have taken the Levites, from among the children of Israel instead of every firstborn, who opens the womb among the children of Israel. Therefore the Levites shall be mine. 13 Because all the firstborn are mine. On the day that I struck all the firstborn in the land of Egypt, I sanctified to myself all the firstborn in Israel, both man and beast. They shall be mine, I am the Lord. 14 Then the Lord spoke to Moses, in the wilderness of Sinai, saying, 15 Number the children of Levi, by their fathers' houses, by their families, you shall number every male from a month old and above. 16 So Moses numbered them according to the word of the Lord, as he was commanded. 17 These were the sons of Levi, by their names, Gershon, Kohath, and Merari. 18 And these are the names of the sons of Gershon, by their families, Libni, and Shimei. 19 And the sons of Kohath, by their families, Amram, Izhar, Hebron, and Uzziel. 20 And the sons of Merari, by their families, Mahli, and Mushi. These are the families of the Levites, by their fathers' houses. 21 From Gershon came the family of the Libnites, and the family of the Shemites, these were the families of the Gershonites. 22 Those who were numbered, according to the number of all the males from a month old and above, of those who were numbered there were 7,500. 23 The families of the Gershonites were to camp behind the tabernacle westward. 24 And the leader of the father's house of the Gershonites was Eliasaph the son of Lael. 25 The duties of the children of Gershon, in the tabernacle of meeting included the tabernacle, the tent with its covering, the screen for the door of the tabernacle of meeting. 26 The screen for the door of the court, the hangings of the court which are around the tabernacle, and the altar, and their cords, according to all the work relating to them. 27 From Kohath came the family of the Amramites, the family of the Izharites, the family of the Hebronites, and the family of the Uzzielites, these were the families of the Kohathites. 28 According to the number of all the males, from a month old and above, there were 8,600 keeping charge of the sanctuary. 29 The families of the children of Kohath were to camp on the south side of the tabernacle. 30 And the leader of the father's house of the families of the Kohathites was Elizaphan the son of Uzziel. 31 Their duty included the ark, the table, the lampstand, the altars, the utensils of the sanctuary with which they ministered, the screen, and all the work relating to them. 32 And Eleazar the son of Aaron the priest was to be chief over the leaders of the Levites, with oversight of those who kept charge of the sanctuary. 33 From Merari came the family of the Mahlites, and the family of the Mushites, these were the families of Merari. 34 And those who were numbered, according to the number of all the males from a month old and above, were 6,200. 35 The leader of the father's house of the families of Merari was Zuriel the son of Abiel. These were to camp on the north side of the tabernacle. 36 And the appointed duty of the children of Merari included the boards of the tabernacle, its bars, its pillars, its sockets, its utensils, all the work relating to them. 37 And the pillars of the court all around, with their sockets, their bags, and their cords. 38 Moreover those who were to camp before the tabernacle on the east, before the tabernacle of meeting, were Moses, Aaron, and his sons, keeping charge of the sanctuary, to meet the needs of the children of Israel, but the outsider, who came near was to be put to death. 39 All who were numbered of the Levites, whom Moses and Aaron numbered at the commandment of the Lord, by their families, all the males from a month old and above, were 22,000. 40 Then the Lord said to Moses, Number all the firstborn males of the children of Israel, from a month old and above, and take the number of their names. 41 And you shall take the Levites for me, I am the Lord, instead of all the firstborn among the children of Israel, and the livestock of the Levites instead of all the firstborn among the livestock of the children of Israel. 42 So Moses numbered all the firstborn among the children of Israel, as the Lord commanded him. 43 And all the firstborn males, according to the number of names from a month old and above, of those who were numbered of them, were 22,273. 44 Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, 45 Take the Levites instead of all the firstborn among the children of Israel, and the livestock of the Levites instead of their livestock. The Levites shall be mine, I am the Lord. 46 And, for the redemption of the 273 of the firstborn of the children of Israel, who are more than the number of the Levites, 47 You shall take 5 shekels for each one individually, you shall take them in the currency of the shekel of the sanctuary, the shekel of 20 gerahs. 48 And you shall give the money, with which the excess number of them is redeemed, to Aaron, and his sons. 49 So Moses took the redemption money, from those who were over and above those who were redeemed by the Levites. 50 From the firstborn of the children of Israel he took the money, 1,365 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary. 51 And Moses gave their redemption money to Aaron, and his sons, according to the word of the Lord, as the Lord commanded Moses. For then the Lord spoke to Moses and Aaron, saying, To take a census of the sons of Kohath, from among the children of Levi, by their families, by their father's house. 3 From 30 years old and above, even to 50 years old, all who enter the service to do the work in the tabernacle of meeting. 4 This is the service of the sons of Kohath, in the tabernacle of meeting, relating to the most holy things. 5 When the camp prepares the journey, Aaron and his sons shall come, and they shall take down the covering veil, and cover the ark of the testimony with it. 6 Then they shall put on it a covering of badger skins, and spread over that a cloth entirely of blue, and they shall insert its poles. 7 On the table of showbread they shall spread a blue cloth, and put on it the dishes, the pans, the bowls, and the pitchers for pouring, and the showbread shall be on it. 8 They shall spread over them a scarlet cloth, and cover the same with a covering of badger skins, and they shall insert its poles. 9 And they shall take a blue cloth, and cover the lampstand of the light, with its lamps, its wick trimmers, its trays, and all its oil vessels, with which they service it. 10 Then they shall put it with all its utensils in a covering of badger skins, and put it on a carrying beam. 11 Over the golden altar they shall spread a blue cloth, and cover it with a covering of badger skins, and they shall insert its poles. 12 And they shall take all the utensils of service with which they minister in the sanctuary, put them in a blue cloth, cover them with a covering of badger skins, and put them on a carrying beam. 13 Also they shall take away the ashes from the altar, and spread a purple cloth over it. 14 They shall put on it all its implements with which they minister there, the fire pans, the forks, the shovels, the basins, and all the utensils of the altar, and they shall spread on it a covering of badger skins, and insert its poles. 15 And when Aaron and his sons have finished covering the sanctuary, and all the furnishings of the sanctuary, when the camp is set to go, then the sons of Kohath shall come to carry them, but they shall not touch any holy thing, lest they die. These are the things in the tabernacle of meeting which the sons of Kohath are to carry. 16 The appointed duty of Eleazar the son of Aaron the priest is the oil for the light, the sweet incense, the daily grain offering, the anointing oil, the oversight of all the tabernacle, of all that is in it, with the sanctuary, and its furnishings. 17 Then the Lord spoke to Moses and Aaron, saying, 18 Do not cut off the tribe of the families of the Kohathites from among the Levites. 19 But do this in regard to them, that they may live and not die when they approach the most holy things. Aaron and his sons shall go in, and appoint each of them to his service, and his task. 20 But they shall not go in to watch, while the holy things are being covered, lest they die. 21 Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, 22 Also take a census of the sons of Gershon, by their father's house, by their families. 23 From 30 years old and above, even to 50 years old, you shall number them, all who enter to perform the service, to do the work in the tabernacle of meeting. 24 This is the service of the families of the Gershonites, in serving and carrying. 25 They shall carry the curtains of the tabernacle, and the tabernacle of meeting with its covering, the covering of badger skins, that is on it, the screen for the door of the tabernacle of meeting. 26 The screen for the door of the gate of the court, the hangings of the court which are around the tabernacle and altar, and their cords, all the furnishings for their service, and all that is made for these things, so shall they serve. 27 Aaron and his sons shall assign all the service of the sons of the Gershonites, all their tasks, and all their service. And you shall appoint to them all their tasks as their duty. 28 This is the service of the families of the sons of Gershon, in the tabernacle of meeting. And their duties shall be under the authority of Ithamar the son of Aaron the priest. 29 As for the sons of Merari, you shall number them by their families, and by their father's house. 30 From 30 years old and above, even to 50 years old, you shall number them, every one who enters the service to do the work of the tabernacle of meeting. 31 And this is what they must carry as all their service for the tabernacle of meeting, the boards of the tabernacle, its bars, its pillars, its sockets. 32 And the pillars around the court with their sockets, pegs, and cords, with all their furnishings, and all their service, and you shall assign to each man by name the items he must carry. 33 This is the service of the families of the sons of Merari, as all their service for the tabernacle of meeting, under the authority of Ithamar the son of Aaron the priest. 34 And Moses, Aaron, and the leaders of the congregation numbered the sons of the Kohathites, by their families, and by their father's house. 35 From 30 years old and above, even to 50 years old, every one who entered the service for work in the tabernacle of meeting. 36 And those who were numbered by their families were 2,750. 37 These were the ones who were numbered of the families of the Kohathites, all who might serve in the tabernacle of meeting, whom Moses and Aaron numbered according to the commandment of the Lord by the hand of Moses. 38 And those who were numbered of the sons of Gershon, by their families, and by their father's house. 39 From 30 years old and above, even to 50 years old, every one who entered the service for work in the tabernacle of meeting. 40 Those who were numbered by their families, by their father's house, were 2,630. 41 These are the ones who were numbered of the families of the sons of Gershon, of all who might serve in the tabernacle of meeting, whom Moses and Aaron numbered according to the commandment of the Lord. 42 Those of the families of the sons of Merari, who were numbered, by their families, by their father's house. 43 From 30 years old and above, even to 50 years old, every one who entered the service for work in the tabernacle of meeting. 44 Those who were numbered by their families were 3,200. 45 These are the ones who were numbered of the families of the sons of Merari, whom Moses and Aaron numbered according to the word of the Lord by the hand of Moses. 46 All who were numbered of the Levites, whom Moses, Aaron, and the leaders of Israel numbered, by their families, and by their fathers' houses. 47 from 30 years old and above, even to 50 years old, everyone who came to do the work of service and the work of bearing burdens in the tabernacle of meeting. 48 Those who were numbered were 8,580. 49 According to the commandment of the Lord they were numbered by the hand of Moses, each according to his service, and according to his task, thus were they numbered by him, as the Lord commanded Moses. 5 And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, To command the children of Israel, that they put out of the camp every leper, every one who has a discharge, and whoever becomes defiled by a corpse. 3 You shall put out both male and female, you shall put them outside the camp. That they may not defile their camps, in the midst of which I dwell. 4 And the children of Israel did so, and put them outside the camp, as the Lord spoke to Moses, so the children of Israel did. 5 And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, 6 Speak to the children of Israel, when a man or woman commits any sin, that men commit in unfaithfulness against the Lord, and that person is guilty. 7 Then he shall confess the sin which he has committed. He shall make restitution for his trespass in full, plus 1/5 of it, and give it to the one he has wronged. 8 But if the man has no relative to whom restitution may be made for the restitution for the wrong must go to the Lord for the priest, in addition to the ram of the atonement with which atonement is made for him. 9 Every offering of all the holy things of the children of Israel, which they bring to the priest, shall be his. 10 And every man's holy things shall be his, whatever any man gives the priest shall be his. 11 And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, 12 Speak to the children of Israel, and say to them, If any man's wife goes astray, and behaves unfaithfully toward him. 13 And a man lies with her carnally, and it is hidden from the eyes of her husband, and it is concealed that she has defiled herself, and there was no witness against her, nor was she caught. 14 If the spirit of jealousy comes upon him and he becomes jealous of his wife, who has defiled herself, or if the spirit of jealousy comes upon him and he becomes jealous of his wife, although she has not defiled herself. 15 Then the man shall bring his wife to the priest. He shall bring the offering required for her, 1/10 of an ephah of barley meal, he shall pour no oil on it, and put no frankincense on it, because it is a grain offering of jealousy, an offering for remembering, for bringing iniquity to remembrance. 16 And the priest shall bring her near, and set her before the Lord. 17 The priest shall take holy water in an earthen vessel, and take some of the dust that is on the floor of the tabernacle, and put it into the water. 18 Then the priest shall stand the woman before the Lord, uncover the woman's head, and put the offering for remembering in her hands, which is the grain offering of jealousy. And the priest shall have in his hand the bitter water that brings a curse. 19 And the priest shall put her under oath, and say to the woman, If no man has lain with you, and if you have not gone astray to uncleanness, while under your husband's authority, be free from this bitter water that brings a curse. 20 But if you have gone astray while under your husband's authority, and if you have defiled yourself, and some man other than your husband has lain with you. 21 Then the priest shall put the woman under the oath of the curse, and he shall say to the woman, The Lord make you a curse, and an oath among your people, when the Lord makes your thigh rot, and your belly swell. 22 And may this water that causes the curse go into your stomach, and make your belly swell and your thigh rot. Then the woman shall say, Amen, so be it. 23 Then the priest shall write these curses in a book, and he shall scrape them off into the bitter water. 24 And he shall make the woman drink the bitter water that brings a curse, and the water that brings the curse shall enter her to become bitter. 25 Then the priest shall take the grain offering of jealousy from the woman's hand, shall wave the offering before the Lord, and bring it to the altar. 26 And the priest shall take a handful of the offering, as its memorial portion, burn it on the altar, and afterward make the woman drink the water. 27 When he has made her drink the water, then it shall be, if she has defiled herself, and behaved unfaithfully toward her husband, that the water that brings a curse will enter her, and become bitter, and her belly will swell, her thigh will rot, and the woman will become a curse among her people. 28 But if the woman has not defiled herself, and is clean, then she shall be free, and may conceive children. 29 This is the law of jealousy, when a wife, while under her husband's authority, goes astray and defiles herself. 30 Or when the spirit of jealousy comes upon a man, and he becomes jealous of his wife, then he shall stand the woman before the Lord, and the priest shall execute all this law upon her. 31 Then the man shall be free from iniquity, but that woman shall bear her guilt. 6 Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, To speak to the children of Israel, and say to them, When either a man or woman consecrates an offering to take the vow of a Nazarite, to separate himself to the Lord, 3 He shall separate himself from wine, and similar drink. He shall drink neither vinegar made from wine nor vinegar made from similar drink. Neither shall he drink any grape juice, nor eat fresh grapes or raisins. For all the days of his separation he shall eat nothing that is produced by the grapevine, from seed to skin. 5 All the days of the vow of his separation no razor shall come upon his head, until the days are fulfilled for which he separated himself to the Lord, he shall be holy. Then he shall let the locks of the hair of his head grow. 6 All the days that he separates himself to the Lord he shall not go near a dead body. 7 He shall not make himself unclean even for his father, or his mother, for his brother, or his sister, when they die, because his separation to God is on his head. 8 All the days of his separation he shall be holy to the Lord. 9 And if anyone dies very suddenly beside him, and he defiles his consecrated head, then he shall shave his head on the day of his cleansing, on the seventh day he shall shave it. 10 Then on the eighth day he shall bring 2 turtle doves, or 2 young pigeons to the priest, to the door of the tabernacle of meeting. 11 And the priest shall offer one as a sin offering, and the other as a burnt offering, and make atonement for him, because he sinned in regard to the corpse, and he shall sanctify his head, that same day. 12 He shall consecrate to the Lord the days of his separation, and bring a male lamb in its first year, as a trespass offering, but the former days shall be lost, because his separation was defiled. 13 Now this is the law of the Nazarite. When the days of his separation are fulfilled, he shall be brought to the door of the tabernacle of meeting. 14 And he shall present his offering to the Lord, one male lamb in its first year without blemish, as a burnt offering, one ewe lamb in its first year without blemish, as a sin offering, one ram without blemish, as a peace offering. 15 A basket of unleavened bread, cakes of fine flour mixed with oil, unleavened wafers anointed with oil, and their grain offering with their drink offerings. 16 Then the priest shall bring them before the Lord, and offer his sin offering, and his burnt offering. 17 And he shall offer the ram, as a sacrifice of a peace offering to the Lord, with the basket of unleavened bread. The priest shall also offer its grain offering, and its drink offering. 18 And the Nazarite shall shave his consecrated head at the door of the tabernacle of meeting, and shall take the hair from his consecrated head, and put it on the fire which is under the sacrifice of the peace offering. 19 And the priest shall take the boiled shoulder of the ram, one unleavened cake from the basket, and one unleavened wafer, and put them upon the hands of the Nazarite, after he has shaved his consecrated hair. 20 And the priest shall wave them, as a wave offering before the Lord, they are holy for the priest, together with the breast of the wave offering, and the thigh of the heave offering. After that the Nazarite may drink wine. 21 This is the law of the Nazarite, who vows to the Lord the offering for his separation, and besides that, whatever else his hand is able to provide, according to the vow which he takes, so he must do according to the law of his separation. 22 And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, 23 Speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, This is the way you shall bless the children of Israel. Say to them, 24 The Lord bless you, and keep you. 25 The Lord make his face shine upon you, and be gracious to you. 26 The Lord lift up his countenance upon you, and give you peace. 27 So they shall put my name on the children of Israel, and I will bless them. 7 Now it came to pass, when Moses had finished setting up the tabernacle, that he anointed it, and consecrated it, and all its furnishings, and the altar, and all its utensils, so he anointed them, and consecrated them. To then the leaders of Israel, the heads of their fathers' houses, who were the leaders of the tribes, and over those who were numbered, made an offering. 3 And they brought their offering, before the Lord, 6 cover carts, and 12 oxen, a cart for every 2 of the leaders, and for each one an ox, and they presented them before the tabernacle. 4 Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, 5 Accept these from them, that they may be used in doing the work of the tabernacle of meeting, and you shall give them to the Levites, to every man according to his service. 6 So Moses took the carts and the oxen, and gave them to the Levites. 7 2 carts and 4 oxen he gave to the sons of Gershon, according to their service. 8 and 4 carts and 8 oxen he gave to the sons of Merari, according to their service, under the authority of Ithamar the son of Aaron the priest. 9 But to the sons of Kohath he gave none, because theirs was the service of the holy things, which they carried on their shoulders. 10 Now the leaders offered the dedication offering for the altar, when it was anointed, so the leaders offered their offering, before the altar. 11 For the Lord said to Moses, They shall offer their offering, one lever each day, for the dedication of the altar. 12 And the one who offered his offering on the first day was Nashon the son of Amminadab, from the tribe of Judah. 13 His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 14 One gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 15 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 16 One kid of the goats as a sin offering. 17 And, for the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Nashon the son of Amminadab. 18 On the second day Nethanel the son of Zuar, leader of Issachar, presented an offering. 19 For his offering he offered one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 21 Gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 21 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 22 One kid of the goats, as a sin offering. 23 And, as the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Nethanel the son of Zuar. 24 On the third day Eliab the son of Helon, leader of the children of Zebulun, presented an offering. 25 His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 26 One gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 27 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 28 One kid of the goats, as a sin offering. 29 And, for the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Eliab the son of Helon. 30 On the fourth day Elizur the son of Shadur, leader of the children of Reuben, presented an offering. 31 His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 32 One gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 33 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 34 One kid of the goats, as a sin offering. 35 And, as the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Elizur the son of Shadur. 36 On the fifth day Shalumiel the son of Zuri Shaddai, leader of the children of Simeon, presented an offering. 37 His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 38 One gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 39 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 40 One kid of the goats as a sin offering. 41 And, as the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Shalumiel the son of Zuri Shaddai. 42 On the sixth day Eliasaph the son of Duel, leader of the children of Gad, presented an offering. 43 His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 44 One gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 45 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 46 one kid of the goats, as a sin offering. 47 And as the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Eliasaph the son of Duel. 48 On the seventh day Elishama the son of Ammon, leader of the children of Ephraim, presented an offering. 49 His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 51 Gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 51 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 52 One kid of the goats, as a sin offering. 53 And as the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Elishama the son of Ammon. 54 On the eighth day Gamaliel the son of Pedazur, leader of the children of Manasseh, presented an offering. 55 His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 56 One gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 57 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 58 One kid of the goats, as a sin offering. 59 And as the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Gamaliel the son of Pedazur. 60 On the ninth day Abidan the son of Gideoni, leader of the children of Benjamin, presented an offering. 61 His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 62 One gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 63 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 64 One kid of the goats, as a sin offering. 65 And as the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Abidan the son of Gideoni. 66 On the tenth day Ahitzer the son of Amishadde, leader of the children of Dan, presented an offering. 67 His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 68 One gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 69 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 70 One kid of the goats, as a sin offering. 71 And as the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Ahitzer the son of Amishadde. 72 On the 11th day Pagiel the son of Okran, leader of the children of Asher, presented an offering. 73 His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 74 One gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 75 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 76 One kid of the goats, as a sin offering. 77 And as the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Pagiel the son of Okran. 78 On the 12th day Ahira the son of Anan, leader of the children of Naphtali, presented an offering. 79 His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil, as a grain offering. 81 Gold pan of 10 shekels, full of incense. 81 One young bull, one ram, and one male lamb in its first year, as a burnt offering. 82 One kid of the goats, as a sin offering. 83 And as the sacrifice of peace offerings, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs in their first year. This was the offering of Ahira the son of Enan. 84 This was the dedication offering for the altar from the leaders of Israel, when it was anointed, 12 silver platters, 12 silver bowls, and 12 gold pans. 85 Each silver platter weighed 130 shekels, and each bowl 70 shekels. All the silver of the vessels weighed 2,400 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary. 86 The 12 gold pans full of incense weighed 10 shekels apiece, according to the shekel of the sanctuary. All the gold of the pans weighed 120 shekels. 87 All the oxen for the burnt offering were 12 young bulls, the rams 12, the male lambs in their first year 12, with their grain offering, and the kids of the goats, as a sin offering 12. 88 And all the oxen for the sacrifice of peace offerings were 24 bulls, the rams 60, the male goats 60, and the lambs in their first year 60. This was the dedication offering for the altar, after it was anointed. 89 Now when Moses went into the tabernacle of meeting to speak with him, he heard the voice of one speaking to him from above the mercy seat, that was on the ark of the testimony, from between the two cherubim, thus he spoke to him. 8 And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, To speak to Aaron, and say to him, When you arrange the lamps, the seven lamps shall give light in front of the lampstand. And Aaron did so, he arranged the lamps to face toward the front of the lampstand, as the Lord commanded Moses. For now this workmanship of the lampstand was hammered gold, from its shaft to its flowers it was hammered work. According to the pattern which the Lord had shown Moses, so he made the lampstand. 5 Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, 6 Take the Levites from among the children of Israel, and cleanse them ceremonially. 7 Thus you shall do to them to cleanse them, sprinkle water of purification on them, and let them shave all their body, and let them wash their clothes, and so make themselves clean. 8 Then let them take a young bull with its grain offering of fine flour mixed with oil, and you shall take another young bull, as a sin offering. 9 And you shall bring the Levites, before the tabernacle of meeting, and you shall gather together the whole congregation of the children of Israel. 10 So you shall bring the Levites, before the Lord, and the children of Israel shall lay their hands on the Levites. 11 And Aaron shall offer the Levites, before the Lord, like a wave offering from the children of Israel, that they may perform the work of the Lord. 12 Then the Levites shall lay their hands on the heads of the young bulls, and you shall offer one, as a sin offering, and the other as a burnt offering to the Lord, to make atonement for the Levites. 13 And you shall stand the Levites before Aaron, and his sons, and then offer them like a wave offering to the Lord. 14 Thus you shall separate the Levites, from among the children of Israel, and the Levites shall be mine. 15 After that the Levites shall go into service the tabernacle of meeting. So you shall cleanse them, and offer them like a wave offering. 16 For they are wholly given to me, from among the children of Israel, I have taken them for myself instead of all who open the womb, the firstborn of all the children of Israel. 17 For all the firstborn among the children of Israel are mine, both man and beast. On the day that I struck all the firstborn in the land of Egypt I sanctified them to myself. 18 I have taken the Levites instead of all the firstborn of the children of Israel. 19 And I have given the Levites, as a gift to Aaron, and his sons from among the children of Israel, to do the work for the children of Israel, in the tabernacle of meeting, and to make atonement, for the children of Israel, that there be no plague among the children of Israel, when the children of Israel come near the sanctuary. 20 Thus Moses and Aaron, and all the congregation of the children of Israel did to the Levites, according to all that the Lord commanded Moses concerning the Levites, so the children of Israel did to them. 21 And the Levites purified themselves and washed their clothes, then Aaron presented them like a wave offering before the Lord, and Aaron made atonement for them to cleanse them. 22 After that the Levites went in to do their work in the tabernacle of meeting before Aaron and his sons, as the Lord commanded Moses concerning the Levites, so they did to them. 23 Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, 24 This is what pertains to the Levites, from 25 years old and above one may enter to perform service, in the work of the tabernacle of meeting. 25 And, at the age of 50 years they must cease performing this work, and shall work no more. 26 They may minister with their brethren in the tabernacle of meeting, to attend to needs, but they themselves shall do no work. Thus you shall do to the Levites regarding their duties. 9. Now the Lord spoke to Moses, in the wilderness of Sinai, in the first month of the second year, after they had come out of the land of Egypt, saying, to let the children of Israel keep the Passover, at its appointed time. 3. On the 14th day of this month, at twilight, you shall keep it at its appointed time. According to all its rites and ceremonies you shall keep it. 4. So Moses told the children of Israel, that they should keep the Passover. 5. And they kept the Passover, on the 14th day of the first month, at twilight, in the wilderness of Sinai, according to all that the Lord commanded Moses, so the children of Israel did. 6. Now there were certain men who were defiled by a human corpse, so that they could not keep the Passover, on that day, and they came before Moses and Aaron that day. 7. And those men said to him, we became defiled by a human corpse. Why are we kept from presenting the offering of the Lord at its appointed time among the children of Israel? 8. And Moses said to them, stand still, that I may hear what the Lord will command concerning you. 9. Then the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, 10. Speak to the children of Israel, saying, if any one of you or your posterity is unclean because of a corpse, or is far away on a journey, he may still keep the Lord's Passover. 11. On the 14th day of the second month, at twilight, they may keep it. They shall eat it with unleavened bread, and bitter herbs. 12. They shall eat none of it until morning, nor break one of its bones. According to all the ordinances of the Passover they shall keep it. 13. But the man who is clean, and is not on a journey, and ceases to keep the Passover, that same person shall be cut off from among his people, because he did not bring the offering of the Lord at its appointed time, that man shall bear his sin. 14. And if a stranger dwells among you, and would keep the Lord's Passover, he must do so according to the rite of the Passover, and according to its ceremony, you shall have one ordinance, both for the stranger, and the native of the land. 15. Now on the day that the tabernacle was raised up, the cloud covered the tabernacle, the tent of the testimony, from evening until morning it was above the tabernacle, like the appearance of fire. 16. So it was always, the cloud covered it by day, and the appearance of fire by night. 17. Whenever the cloud was taken up from above the tabernacle, after that the children of Israel would journey, and in the place where the cloud settled, there the children of Israel would pitch their tents. 18. At the command of the Lord the children of Israel would journey, and at the command of the Lord they would camp, as long as the cloud stayed above the tabernacle they remained and camped. 19. Even when the cloud continued long, many days, above the tabernacle, the children of Israel kept the charge of the Lord, and did not journey. 20. So it was, when the cloud was above the tabernacle a few days, according to the command of the Lord they would remain encamped, and according to the command of the Lord they would journey. 21. So it was, when the cloud remained only from evening until morning, when the cloud was taken up in the morning, then they would journey, whether by day, or by night, whenever the cloud was taken up, they would journey. 22. Whether it was 2 days, a month, or a year, that the cloud remained above the tabernacle, the children of Israel would remain encamped, and not journey, but when it was taken up, they would journey. 23. At the command of the Lord they remained encamped, and at the command of the Lord they journeyed, they kept the charge of the Lord, at the command of the Lord by the hand of Moses. 10. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, to make 2 silver trumpets for yourself, you shall make them of hammered work, you shall use them for calling the congregation, and for directing the movement of the camps. 3. When they blow both of them, all the congregation shall gather before you at the door of the tabernacle of meeting. 4. But if they blow only one, then the leaders, the heads of the divisions of Israel, shall gather to you. 5. When you sound the advance, the camps that lie on the east side shall then begin their journey. 6. When you sound the advance the second time, then the camps that lie on the south side shall begin their journey, they shall sound the call for them to begin their journeys. 7. And when the assembly is to be gathered together, you shall blow, but not sound the advance. 8. The sons of Aaron, the priests, shall blow the trumpets, and these shall be to you, as an ordinance forever throughout your generations. 9. When you go to war in your land against the enemy, who oppresses you, then you shall sound an alarm with the trumpets, and you will be remembered before the Lord your God, and you will be saved from your enemies. 10. Also in the day of your gladness, in your appointed feasts, and at the beginning of your months, you shall blow the trumpets over your burnt offerings, and over the sacrifices of your peace offerings, and they shall be a memorial for you before your God, I am the Lord your God. 11 Now it came to pass on the 20th day of the second month, in the second year, that the cloud was taken up from above the tabernacle of the testimony. 12 And the children of Israel set out from the wilderness of Sinai, on their journeys. Then the cloud settled down in the wilderness of Paran. 13 So they started out for the first time according to the command of the Lord by the hand of Moses. 14 The standard of the camp of the children of Judah set out first according to their armies. Over their army was Nahshon the son of Amminadab. 15 Over the army of the tribe of the children of Issachar was Nethanel the son of Zuar. 16 And over the army of the tribe of the children of Zebulun was Eliab the son of Helon. 17 Then the tabernacle was taken down, and the sons of Gershon, and the sons of Merari set out, carrying the tabernacle. 18 And the standard of the camp of Reuben set out according to their armies. Over their army was Elizur the son of Shadur. 19 Over the army of the tribe of the children of Simeon was Shalumiel the son of Zurishaddai. 20 And over the army of the tribe of the children of Gad was Eliasaph the son of Duel. 21 Then the Kohathites set out, carrying the holy things. The tabernacle would be prepared for their arrival. 22 And the standard of the camp of the children of Ephraim set out according to their armies. Over their army was Elishama the son of Amid. 23 Over the army of the tribe of the children of Manasseh was Gamaliel the son of Pedazur. 24 And over the army of the tribe of the children of Benjamin was Abidan the son of Gideoni. 25 Then the standard of the camp of the children of Dan, the rearguard of all the camps, set out according to their armies. Over their army was Ahitzer the son of Amishaddai. 26 Over the army of the tribe of the children of Asher was Bogiel the son of Okran. 27 And over the army of the tribe of the children of Naphtali was Ahira the son of Anan. 28 Thus was the order of march of the children of Israel, according to their armies, when they began their journey. 29 Now Moses said to Hobab the son of Reuel the Midianite, Moses' father-in-law, we are setting out for the place of which the Lord said, I will give it to you. Come with us, and we will treat you well, for the Lord has promised good things to Israel. 30 And he said to him, I will not go, but I will depart to my own land, and to my relatives. 31 So Moses said, Please do not leave, inasmuch as you know how we are to camp in the wilderness, and you can be our eyes. 32 And it shall be, if you go with us, indeed it shall be, that whatever good the Lord will do to us, the same we will do to you. 33 So they departed from the mountain of the Lord on a journey of 3 days, and the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord went before them for the 3 days' journey, to search out a resting place for them. 34 And the cloud of the Lord was above them by day, when they went out from the camp. 35 So it was, whenever the ark set out, that Moses said, Rise up, O Lord. Let your enemies be scattered, and let those who hate you flee before you. 36 And when it rested, he said, Return, O Lord, to the many thousands of Israel. 11 Now when the people complained, it displeased the Lord, for the Lord heard it, and his anger was aroused. So the fire of the Lord burned among them, and consumed some in the outskirts of the camp. 2 Then the people cried out to Moses, and when Moses prayed to the Lord, the fire was quenched. 3 So he called the name of the place Abrah, because the fire of the Lord had burned among them. 4 Now the mixed multitude who were among them yielded to intense craving, so the children of Israel also wept again and said, Who will give us meat to eat? 5 We remember the fish which we ate freely in Egypt, the cucumbers, the melons, the leeks, the onions, and the garlic. 6 But now our whole being is dried up, there is nothing at all except this manna, before our eyes. 7 Now the manna was like coriander seed, and its color, like the color of dalian. 8 The people went about and gathered it, ground it on millstones, or beat it in the mortar, cooked it in pans, and made cakes of it, and its taste was like the taste of pastry prepared with oil. 9 And when the dew fell on the camp in the night, the manna fell on it. 10 Then Moses heard the people weeping throughout their families, everyone at the door of his tent, and the anger of the Lord was greatly aroused, Moses also was displeased. 11 So Moses said to the Lord, Why have you afflicted your servant? And why have I not found favor in your sight, that you have laid the burden of all these people on me? 12 Did I conceive all these people? Did I beget them, that you should say to me, Carry them in your bosom, as a guardian carries a nursing child, to the land which you swore to their fathers? 13 Where am I to get meat to give to all these people? For they weep all over me, saying, Give us meat, that we may eat. 14 I am not able to bear all these people alone, because the burden is too heavy for me. 15 If you treat me like this, please kill me here and now, if I have found favor in your sight, and do not let me see my wretchedness. 16 So the Lord said to Moses, gather to me 70 men of the elders of Israel, whom you know to be the elders of the people and officers over them. Bring them to the tabernacle of meeting, that they may stand there with you. 17 Then I will come down and talk with you there. I will take of the spirit that is upon you and will put the same upon them, and they shall bear the burden of the people with you, that you may not bear it yourself alone. 18 Then you shall say to the people, consecrate yourselves for tomorrow, and you shall eat meat, for you have wept in the hearing of the Lord, saying, who will give us meat to eat? For it was well with us in Egypt. Therefore the Lord will give you meat, and you shall eat. 19 You shall eat, not one day, nor 2 days, nor 5 days, nor 10 days, nor 20 days. 20 But for a whole month, until it comes out of your nostrils, and becomes loathsome to you, because you have despised the Lord, who is among you, and have wept before him, saying, why did we ever come up out of Egypt? 21 And Moses said, the people, whom I am among, are 600,000 men on foot, yet you have said, I will give them meat, that they may eat for a whole month. 22 Shall flocks and herds be slaughtered for them, to provide enough for them? Or shall all the fish of the sea be gathered together for them, to provide enough for them? 23 And the Lord said to Moses, has the Lord's arm been shortened? Now you shall see, whether what I say will happen to you, or not. 24 So Moses went out and told the people the words of the Lord, and he gathered the 70 men of the elders of the people, and placed them around the tabernacle. 25 Then the Lord came down in the cloud, and spoke to him, and took of the spirit that was upon him, and placed the same upon the 70 elders, and it happened, when the spirit rested upon them, that they prophesied, although they never did so again. 26 But 2 men had remained in the camp, the name of one was Eldad, and the name of the other Medad, and the spirit rested upon them. Now they were among those listed, but who had not gone out to the tabernacle, yet they prophesied in the camp. 27 And a young man ran, and told Moses, and said, Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp. 28 So Joshua the son of Nun, Moses' assistant, one of his choice men, answered and said, Moses my lord, forbid them. 29 Then Moses said to him, are you zealous for my sake? Oh, that all the Lord's people were prophets, and that the Lord would put his spirit upon them. 30 And Moses returned to the camp, he, and the elders of Israel. 31 Now a wind went out from the Lord, and it brought quail from the sea, and left them fluttering near the camp, about a day's journey on this side, and about a day's journey on the other side, all around the camp, and about 2 cubits above the surface of the ground. 32 And the people stayed up all that day, all night, and all the next day, and gathered the quail. He who gathered least gathered 10 homers, and they spread them out for themselves all around the camp. 33 But while the meat was still between their teeth, before it was chewed, the wrath of the Lord was aroused against the people, and the Lord struck the people with a very great plague. 34 So he called the name of that place Kibroth Hattaavah, because there they buried the people who had yielded to craving. 35 From Kibroth Hattaavah the people moved to Hazeroth, and camped at Hazeroth. 12 Then Miriam and Aaron spoke against Moses, because of the Ethiopian woman whom he had married, for he had married an Ethiopian woman. 2 So they said, has the Lord indeed spoken only through Moses? Has he not spoken through us also? And the Lord heard it. 3 Now the man Moses was very humble, more than all men who were on the face of the earth. For suddenly the Lord said to Moses, Aaron, and Miriam, come out, you three, to the tabernacle of meeting. So the three came out. 5 Then the Lord came down in the pillar of cloud, and stood in the door of the tabernacle, and called Aaron and Miriam. And they both went forward. 6 Then he said, if there is a prophet among you, I, the Lord, make myself known to him in a vision, I speak to him in a dream. 7 Not so with my servant Moses, he is faithful in all my house. 8 I speak with him face to face, even plainly, and not in dark sayings, and he sees the form of the Lord. Why then were you not afraid to speak against my servant Moses? 9 So the anger of the Lord was aroused against them, and he departed. 10 And when the cloud departed from above the tabernacle, suddenly Miriam became leprous, as white as snow. Then Aaron turned toward Miriam, and there she was, a leper. 11. So Aaron said to Moses, "Oh, my Lord, please do not lay this sin on us, in which we have done foolishly, and in which we have sinned." 12. Please do not let her be as one dead, whose flesh is half consumed when he comes out of his mother's womb. 13. So Moses cried out to the Lord, saying, "Please heal her, O God, I pray." 14. Then the Lord said to Moses, "If her father had but spit in her face, would she not be shamed 7 days? Let her be shut out of the camp 7 days, and afterward she may be received again." 15. So Miriam was shut out of the camp 7 days, and the people did not journey till Miriam was brought in again. 16. And afterward the people moved from Hazeroth and camped in the wilderness of Paran. 13. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "To send men to spy out the land of Canaan, which I am giving to the children of Israel, from each tribe of their fathers you shall send a man, every one a leader among them." 3. So Moses sent them from the wilderness of Paran according to the command of the Lord, all of them men, who were heads of the children of Israel. 4. Now these were their names, from the tribe of Reuben, Shammu the son of Zachar. 5. From the tribe of Simeon, Shaphat the son of Hori. 6. From the tribe of Judah, Caleb the son of Jephunneh. 7. From the tribe of Issachar, Igal the son of Joseph. 8. From the tribe of Ephraim, Hoshea the son of Nun. 9. From the tribe of Benjamin, Palti the son of Rapha. 10. From the tribe of Zebulun, Gadiel the son of Sodai.